Brando, I see you've come to take over the show today. Well, not if I have anything to do about it. Whose show is it now, Brando? Very good. It is mine, Jonzo.
You dare show your face around here?
I will not let you take over this show today, eh? Oh, God! Ho-ho-ho!
You were saying?
And welcome to the So-and-So Show. What an incredible show we have for you today, right, Brandon?
Yeah, well, incredible is a strong word.
Well, yeah, and it's the perfect word for today's show.
I don't think so.
Okay, how about strum-diddly-umptious? Strum-diddly-umptious, when words don't suffice, and only a strum will do.
Yeah, that's definitely not the word.
Okay, what word would you use to describe today's show?
Fine.
Yeah, fine. Come up with a word.
Fine.
We're waiting.
Fine.
No, you don't have to get upset with me. I'll still be patient with you.
Listen. Fine.
Fine?
Fine, yes. I think today's show will be fine.
Fine?
Mm-hmm. Or...
That's it?
Satisfactory.
Satisfactory? Are you kidding me? The show is amazing today.
Meh.
Buddy, what's going on?
Nothing. I just don't want to get too excited. That's all.
Why not?
Because... life can sometimes be hard, and I don't think that we should forget that.
Life can be hard, but life can be great, too.
Yeah, but if I remind myself that things can always get much, much worse than when they actually do get worse, I won't be surprised.
Okay. What if something happens that is really exciting to you? Oh, like this.
I love that. That is so funny.
Yeah.
I remember that.
What just happened?
I thought about the fact that some flowers have thorns, and if you walk by them, they can scratch you.
I don't understand you.
Well, John, it's like this. Dog poo on new shoes and old rotten cabbage. Expired goat's milk and overweight baggage. Using a dull spoon to shave off my scruff. This is just some of my least favorite stuff. Flu germs in smoothies and watered down soda. Hearing the spoilers about Baby Yoda. My leg impaled by a billy goat's gruff. This is just some of my least favorite stuff.
You put a lot of thought into this.
You have no idea. Bee stings on eyelids and freeze pops in bathrooms. Falling from tall trees, smelling diesel car fumes. Rice Krispies with mayonnaise, not marshmallow fluff. This is just some of my least favorite stuff. When I'm laughing, when my team wins, when I'm feeling rad, I simply remember my least favorite stuff, and then I don't feel so glad.
It's Bible story time with Kellen.
What's up, fellas?
Just trying to cheer this guy up.
Why? What's wrong?
Well, Kellen, it's like this.
No!
Not sure what's going on, but can you guys help me out with today's story?
Sure, what did you have in mind?
This. Hello, and welcome to the Host Feud, We are joined today by our contestants, Brandon's team and John's team. Brandon, who have you brought with you today?
It looks like I have a mannequin with my picture on it. Not sure how helpful that's going to be. Speak for yourself, Brandon. Okay, that's weird. And also, I have a picture of my childhood cat, Catherine the Great.
Meow. Hello, Kellen.
Fantastic. John, who's on your team?
Well, I have an enlarged picture from my 8th grade yearbook.
Hey, Kellen. Hey, me. You look great.
No, you look great.
Aww.
And also on my team is a potato.
Top of the morning, everyone.
Okay. Well, there you go. Let's hop to it. Let's play the host feud. The top 8 answers are on the board. We ask the question. According to the Apostle Paul in Philippians 4:8, what kinds of things should you think about? Brandon?
Dull things.
Dull things.
Dull things, yes.
All right, let's see dull things. Ooh, I am so sorry, Brandon. John?
Things that are noble. Yeah, you should think of noble
things.
Good
answer.
All right, let's see noble. Number
yes.
2, noble things. John, do you want to play or pass?
What do you want to do?
Play. Let's play. We're going to play.
Let's play. We're going to play, Kellen.
Okay, I think we're going to play, Kellen. We're going to play.
Kellen.
We're going to play.
They're going to play. John's yearbook photo. According to Paul, what kind of things should you think about?
I'm going to have to say excellent things.
Good answer. Good answer.
Good answer.
All right. Let's see excellent things.
Yes.
Number 7, well done. Potato, what do you think about?
Well, as a potato, people always want to add things to me or cut me into little pieces. Potato tots, french fries, hash browns. But I prefer just being a pure potato. So I'm going to say pure things.
Good answer. That's a good answer.
Oh, good answer, good answer.
All right, let's see pure things. Number 4, nice job, potato. Back to you, John.
Let's go with lovely things.
Good answer. Good answer.
Show me lovely. You got it. John's yearbook photo. According to Paul, what kind of things should you think about?
I don't know. How about things or people you respect?
Good answer. Good answer.
Good answer. Good answer.
8th grade John wants you to show him some respect. Number 6, John's team, you are on a roll. Potato, according to Paul, what kinds of things should you think about?
Oh, I know what I think about a lot. Ketchup. Good answer.
Good answer.
Good answer.
Good answer.
Show me ketchup. Ooh, that was your first strike. 2 more and Brandon's team has a chance to steal. What are you thinking about, John?
What would Paul say? I'm thinking about praiseworthy things? Praiseworthy things.
Yes, good answer.
Show me
good
praiseworthy.
Answer.
Number 8, worthy of praise. John's yearbook photo?
What was the question again?
According to Paul, what kinds of things should you think about?
Right.
Oh, well, show me what is right.
No, I was just...
Oh, you got it. Number 3.
Gnarly.
1 answer left. Potato?
Corned beef hash.
Good answer.
No, what? No, that's just wrong.
Show me corned beef hash. Shucking. It comes down to this, John. 1 answer left. You get it right and you win. You miss it and Brandon's team gets a chance to steal. The number 1 answer is still on the board. According to the Apostle Paul in Philippians 4:8, what kinds of things should you think about?
I don't know.
We need an answer. Ooh, so sorry, John's team. All right, Brandon's team, do you have an answer?
A balls of yarn. Goldfish. Myself. Balls
things that
yarn.
Are scary.
Did I say that?
Scary catnip. Things.
Really scary things. Scary things. So scary. Man, I wish this was a true or false quiz. That's it. True or false. True. You think of things that are true.
That's it. Brandon's team wins.
All right. Yeah, we win. Yeah.
Thank you to both our contestants. This was the host feed. Yeah. We'll see you next time.
Great job. Great job. Good on ya.
That was fun, Kellen.
Yeah, definitely.
No doubt. Thanks for helping, guys. So, to review, the Apostle Paul wrote this in Philippians 4:8. Finally, my brothers and sisters, always think about what is true. Think about what is noble, right, and pure. Think about what is lovely and worthy of respect. If anything is excellent or worthy of praise, think about those kinds of things.
Oh, I think I get it. I've been choosing to think about things that are negative, things that aren't lovely or pure or true. I should be focusing on what Paul wrote about instead.
Definitely. It may not feel like it sometimes, but you are in charge of what you think. Maybe you can't control every single thought that enters your brain, but you can definitely decide what you focus on. And if we focus on these things, it can help us live and think a little more like Jesus.
Thanks, Kellen.
You got it. I'll see you guys later.
See you.
Yeah, bye, Kellen.
What are you doing?
I'm trying to control what I think about. It is not easy.
Oh, well, don't think about me dressed like a Ninja Turtle going down a water slide.
Oh, man, now that's all I can think about.
Reveal the question!
Oh, what do you tend to focus on? Be honest.
Sometimes I focus on what can go wrong, but after today, I'm going to work on that.
Oh, great. And I'm going to focus on excellent and true things like pizza with extra cheese and God's love.
Now I'm thinking about pizza.
Lunch?
Let's do it.
Awesome.
See y'all later.
Hey, hey.
What?
You know what? I'll provide some lunch music.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Strumdiddlyumptious. On guard!
Okay, if I have to, okay.
Aha! All right. Oh, good parry, good parry. Ah, no, I see, where your move, look at that. Aha, you can't.
Yeah, no, you're
dizzy.
Okay, yeah. Ooh.
Oh, exhausting, but I won't give up.
Hey, what's that?
Huh? Oh, the old what's that? I should have seen it coming.
Oh. Yeah, now it makes sense.
Maybe once in a while, you cover up an itty bitty lie with a big fat smile. But an itty bitty lie still lying, that's not your style. Boots stick to the middle of the path from mile to mile. Maybe you want it real bad, so you take it. Maybe you make the promise, but then you break it. Maybe you didn't learn the words, so you fake it. And you feel a little low. But if instead you move straight ahead, keeping your promises, you'll be living straight up. If you move too far to the side, then you're gonna get stuck. Might feel like a little lie, but it's gonna catch up. Do what you say you're gonna do, you'll be on your way up. Said you're on your way up, you'll be living straight up. things that good friends do. And everybody's still a good friend who sticks like glue. Cause everybody did what they said and everybody was true. Maybe you wanted it but you didn't take it. Maybe you promised and then you didn't break it. Maybe you learned the words so you didn't fake it. And now everybody knows. But if instead you move straight ahead, keeping your promises, you'll be living straight up. If you move too far to the side, then you're gonna get stuck. Might feel like a little lie, but it's gonna catch up. Do what you say you're gonna do, you'll be on your way up. Said you're on your way up, you'll be living straight up. If you move too far to the side, then you're gonna get stuck. Might feel like a little lie, but it's gonna catch up. Do what you say you're gonna do, you'll be on your way up. Said you're on your way up. You can choose to be true, not just to everybody else, but true to you. You can choose to be true, not just to everybody else.